Last night, LeBron James became the all-time leading scorer in the NBA. But what I wanted to address in this video is LeBron James' narcissism and luciferic pride. I'm going to show you in just a moment his speech where he doesn't give any praise or glory to God, but everything in his career really centers around him. So some might say, why am I addressing this? Well, LeBron James is one of the biggest sports icons in American culture. And American culture has such a big issue of sports idolatry. And so I'm going to discuss that a little bit in this video. The issue isn't so much with him thanking his family, recognizing his family, but he actually ends the entire speech in a profanity without giving any praise or glory to God.
I just want to say I thank you so much, because I wouldn't be me without y'all. All y'all help, all y'all passion, all y'all sacrifices helped me get to this point. And to the NBA, to Adam Silver, to the late, great David Stern, I thank you guys so much for allowing me to be a part of something I've always dreamed about. And I would never, ever, in a million years, dreamt this even better than what it is tonight. So, fuck, man. Thank you, guys.
Of a franchise that was starting up and I had the number one pick, I'd take me. But that's just me, because I believe in myself. I know what I bring to the table. A guy that's been able to transform his game over the course of 20 years to be able to play any position in this league and excel at any position.
Someone might say that it's quite an accusation to say that LeBron James has luciferic pride, but in Isaiah we see the I wills of Satan, and everything about Satan's nature, everything about Lucifer's nature centers around self. And so this is the after game press conference where he asks some questions, and everything centers around himself.
But you always want to do it again, you know, and it's been a pleasure and an honor so far in my career. Within these 20 years, that through the ups, through the downs, through the ins and outs, through the trials and tribulations, I've always maintained me. And I've done it my way. I didn't want to emulate anybody. I wanted to give praise to everyone that came before me. I wanted to acknowledge that I'm a historian of the game, but I didn't want to emulate nobody. I wanted to be myself. And you know, if you stay true to yourself, I think you always feel better about the outcome, win, lose, or draw in life. So, but it's been great. It's been great. And I'm not going nowhere, but it sounds like I am. But I'm going to get something to eat.
See, the issue with sports idolatry is that people look to another man or woman. People put all of their hope, all of their joy, all of their satisfaction in how that person performs on the court or on the field. This is another example of LeBron James' pride and arrogance. After scoring on three opposing players, he gets up off of the ground and curses, saying that he is the effing GOAT, which means greatest of all time. And so this guy definitely has a pride issue, and he's the one that most young people and many athletes in our country are looking to.
He picked his ass up like 2 months ago. He thought I was blowing smoke up his ass early in the season when I said, Deli would tear that bear up. He damn near gave his life last year in the finals. He's a big motherfucker, ain't he? I said, you kind of right, huh? This is me and you being on our Olympic team in 04, which was a shit show, and you looked at me like, man, you don't know me. Shut the fuck up.
LeBron James has 136,700,000 Instagram followers. One of the other issues is LeBron James' close friendship with Jay-Z and Beyoncé. Now, Jay-Z and Beyonce are two of the most popular rap artists and musical artists in our culture and our country. And their music has just really brought a defiling in the minds of youth and young adults, and really for anybody who watches it or listens to their music.
And then Jay-Z came out.
Yeah,
back
he put him in his place. I guess he put him back in his place.
So what's it like to get you a man like that?
Oh, it's great.
This is LeBron James sharing about his friendship.
You know, to have a big brother.
Jay-Z.
I mean, we all know if you have a big brother, stick up for you. Just like the movie, Sheon was like our hey, listen, something going on, let me know. And I, you know, Jay's a big brother of mine, and for him to do that, I think it's humbling to know that you have people that's great in other professions.
They've done lots of events together. They have partnered together in many different avenues. You know, how sad is it to be given one of the greatest platforms and to not use it for the glory of God? To not use it to point people to the truth, but instead to just build an empire. And so in many ways, you know, that's what LeBron James has done. And really, sadly, that's what most of the world does when it's given platform and opportunity. It partners with things that aren't of God and people that aren't of God to just advance self. And that's why I'm making the case that LeBron James' pride is luciferic. In the past couple years, LeBron James has also gotten himself into a little bit of trouble being a commenter on Twitter. You know, here is an example of him actually being in support of abortion on the day that Roe v. Wade was overturned. And there's been many other things you could look up as well.
Type of cats to hang around, Jay, you know, just, you know, randomly just fall up on the bus, you know, you know. Hottest guy in the country in the NBA right
yes,
now.
Yes, sir.
We got LeBron James in here. What's up, Playboy?
What's going on with you, man?
I'm chilling, man. But now, what brings you to the concert? I mean, we're in Cleveland, so.
Come on, man. You know what brings me to the concert. This man sitting right here next to me.
Yeah?
You know, I'm part of the Rock. So I'm here, you know, supporting my man. And you know, I brought my clique out here. They wanted to see everybody. So just showing our support to everybody that's trying to make it happen.
Okay, now, when you say you're part of the Rock, I mean, are you signed to the Rock? Are you just a Rock fan? I mean, what does that mean?
That's extended family
that's
member
extended
right
family.
There.
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
Yeah, you coming soon, you're going to see me in a Rock jersey at the Rucker, too.
Oh, yeah?
This is a brand new ad from Nike that glorifies LeBron James and actually puts him in the place of God.
We've witnessed him do so much already. We've heard about the things this man can do already.
Cleveland is a city of champions once again.
And we just can't help but celebrate him. Haters, go ahead and recognize that when you speak on his name, you're gonna go higher, higher, higher.
James!
So excuse me while I cut a step, because I can't help but to honor him, and I can't help but to lift him up, and I got one last question for you.
In sports, there's a term called GOAT. It stands for greatest of all time. And so there's been so many debates in every type of sport, in basketball, who's the greatest of all time, in football, who's the greatest of all time. But the truth is there's one person who is the greatest of all time, and that is Jesus Christ. Everybody else is really just seeking to fill themselves with some kind of passing ego or passing praise from man or woman. And so LeBron James is oftentimes considered himself to be the GOAT. But the truth is that we all have to become like sheep and follow Jesus. We all have to be humble and we all have to lay down our rebellion. There's a verse in Proverbs that says, "Pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before a fall." And that's Proverbs 16:18. Jesus also dealt with this idea of being sheep. It says in Matthew 25, 31 through 46, when the Son of Man comes in his glory and all the angels with him, then he will sit on his glorious throne. Before him will be gathered all the nations, and he will separate people from one another as a shepherd separates the sheep. And he will place the sheep on his right, but the goats on the left. Then the king will say to those on the right, come, you who are blessed by my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Later on in verse 41, Jesus says, then he will say to those on his left, depart from me, you cursed, into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. So this is something to think about concerning our culture, sports idolatry, who is the goat, and are we ever supposed to be seeking to be goats, or are we always supposed to be seeking to be sheep? Sports idolatry is a real issue in our culture. So many people literally look to sports as a distraction. They center their lives around sports, and even many people that name the name of Jesus Christ get infinitely more excited about a basket being made or a touchdown than they do about reaching the lost or about praising the Lord in their day-to-day life. And so that is a very real problem. And so that's why I really felt like the Lord wanted me to make this video today. Thanks for checking out this video. Please like and subscribe. And I know it's different than some of our other content, but the Lord put it on my heart today to make this video. Thanks.